Well, the city of Butte is holding a series of economic forums this week to find ways to boost its economy.
MTN's Don Amy tells us how the city wants to encourage young people to settle and work in Butte.
Butte economic leaders know it's important to attract young entrepreneurs to the city.
It's no secret that we're an aging community, and we've always been an aging community throughout the state. We're one of the oldest communities.
Butte is hosting its first Economic Development Week that includes a list of business forums, one of which emphasizes the importance of helping young business owners settle in Butte.
One of the best things about Butte is our affordability. Our cost of living is significantly less than surrounding communities of its size. And so it's a huge opportunity for young people to come here, buy a home, start a family, and get a really dang good job.
Mike Markham, along with co-owner Chris Bradley, opened this fly shop in Butte when he was 25 years old. 13 years later, business is booming. He said success can be made in Butte.
Butte has fallen on some retail hard times for sure, but that negativity of Butte is not there. I mean, you can be successful in Butte, and there's people here to help you too.
Young entrepreneurs like the ones that run the Stonefly here in Butte say they need city leaders to be proactive and to plan ahead if they want to encourage more young entrepreneurs to come to the mining city.
They just need to have an overall plan of what's going to happen for Butte, have some good ideas, and have professionals come in to give the advice that they need to continue on in economic growth.
Will Butte's future remain open? In Butte, John Amy, MTN News.
The event will include a workforce fair at the Copper King Hotel Ballroom beginning at 11 o'clock in the morning Thursday to connect workers with jobs, and that event is free to the public.